Fall is upon us, and there are plenty of ways to embrace the cooler weather, including with food. Joining us this morning, personal chef Kendall Mitchell from True Gourmand to tell us about a tasty fall salad for the season. First, we got to find out, what are we making here?
We're making a panzanella. It's kind of an autumnal take on panzanella. Normally, panzanella is made in the summertime with fresh tomatoes when they're nice and juicy and ripe. But we're going to do a fall version of it with roasted butternut squash, some roasted Michigan apples, red onion, some autumn greens. And then
so panzanella for everyone at home is a type of salad.
It's a type of salad. It's a bread salad.
Sure.
Traditionally, you use an Italian bread like ciabatta or something like that.
What do we have in the pan right now?
This is the red onion, Michigan red onion, which has been roasted.
Yeah, and it's important to let everyone know at home as you're cooking that all of these, all the produce, with the exception of the greens, is all Michigan-made products.
All Michigan
products. That's something that you pride yourself on and with your culinary art.
Absolutely. I think it's important to be a locavore. You want to eat foods that are grown near you and support the economy around you. So I love Michigan products. I think we have a lot of things here. Mm-hmm. People don't know about. It's not just blueberries and strawberries,
right,
or cherries.
Right.
Blueberries and cherries, but we have asparagus. We have honey.
Sure.
Wines are made here.
Yeah.
We have a lot of really great things.
So right now, what are we doing in the pan?
I'm just doing a reheat. A cool thing about this recipe is for fall or for the holidays, we're always looking for some kind of way, a different dish, mm-hmm, right? So this is a different take on a bread salad. We're also looking for things we can make ahead. So all of these things are roasted ahead of time, the butternut squash roasted ahead of time, the apples, the onions, and you can keep those a couple of days ahead in the fridge, and then when you get ready to build it, you can do like we're doing here. Just do a reheat in the pan. Do just a touch of water.
And you know, as we're making this, this has got to be something that you can make and alter for different tastes. How would you suggest altering it for different tastes?
Absolutely. When people hear bread salad, they see the bread, and then for my gluten-free food lovers out there, they're like, well, I can't have that salad. You absolutely can have this. You can use bread that is made with corn flour or any of your favorite gluten-free breads. Mm-hmm. There are a lot of local favorites. I have a couple favorites. Cicero Cakery is a really great one. They're at the farmer's market where I am normally. Vic the Bread Man. There are a couple different ones that are...
You kind of mentioned this and as kind of a precursor to seeing the finished product. Where can folks find you? At the Shelby Township Farmers Market?
Shelby Township Farmers Market. I'm there on Saturdays from 9 till 2.
Okay.
Actually, we're having our Harvest Festival, which is coming up next Saturday. So we'll have some great things for people to see there.
Right now, as we finish up, we're adding a little sage to it. This is the sage that you just chopped.
Just chopped. Nice autumn flavor scent. And then this is our vinaigrette, which is a cider vinaigrette. So then once you get all of this in, we'll toss it, and that's our salad.
And this is the finished product that you can see right here. I'll tell you what. For more information on this recipe, you can find this recipe on our website, WXYZ.com. Click on the As Seen On section there, and that's where you'll find this recipe from Chef Kendall Mitchell. And you can also find him, as you heard him say, Shelby Township Farmers Market. Thanks for joining us this morning.
Thank you, sir.